Welcome back to Full Throttle TV and the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series with Full Throttle Sim Racing. I'm Dean Doucette. In the booth with me, Jared Carr. Jared, we're at Kentucky Speedway in the new configuration tonight.
Yeah, and we already know, Dean, that Kentucky was a challenge for all those years before that. Now we throw another wrench into it. It's a brand new configuration. These guys have not done any official FTSR races with this configuration yet. And I think there's going to be a lot of different things that's going to come into play.
Oh, most definitely there will be. Let's get right into it with our keys to the race tonight. We got the new track config. Of course, nobody ran this track yet. Nobody knows it. They're learning it. It's going to be a true test for these guys out here as they try and decipher these new corners and all the sights and sounds that are available. Okay, so we got fuel mileage tonight. This could be a fuel mileage race. We're on the verge of being able to do 50 laps. And, you know, it's a 100 lap race out there. It could be one of those races. But that goes with, you know, the third key to the race here, early wrecks. If we get wrecks, you throw that all out the window. And we're going to have hard fought racing as we just watched a 71 take a hard lick to the wall. But yeah, the early wrecks, Jared, something that you've got to avoid, and you got to not cause them as well. We're expecting some loose trucks out here tonight, guys setting these things up right on that edge, so we could have some problems early on.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this is a track, surface-wise, it's fairly new because they did a complete repave, changing turn 3 and 4 from what it was originally. The track used to be a lot like Las Vegas, the older Las Vegas, from pre-2006 times, and then they've changed it around to where 1 and 2 are a lot more deeply banked, and then 3 and 4 are a little bit more winding, kind of almost like a Texas style almost in a way. So it's gonna be really unique to see how these guys battle this track. And Dean, with the wrecks, with the new configuration, that's always gonna be something that comes up, is can these guys handle this new configuration? We know Full Throttle Sim Racing, I mean, this year they're only averaging about 2 cautions per race, if you exclude IRP, which is a short track, where we had several cautions there. But otherwise, you know, I think these guys are going to get through it fine, but I think it's going to be a challenge to see how these trucks progress on the long run.
Yeah, it definitely is, and that will be the key, the long run capability. I mean, if we do go under green, we see a lot of fast trucks, but can they hold on? As we look in at the air temp here, 78, track temp at 80, very racy conditions out here, humidity at 44%, a slight wind out of the south, shouldn't be any problem. This is about as racy as they get. These guys setting these up so loose to try and take advantage of that, Jared.
Yeah, for sure. I have to laugh at the humidity, Dean. I mean, being right down the road from this track, I can tell you that humidity is almost 100% from April until August. So 44% must have had a thunderstorm come through already or something before the race started. But yeah, it's going to be great racing conditions. I mean, mostly cloudy. It doesn't really affect at nighttime. But I think it's going to be crucial for some of these guys to get off to a good start. We saw last week Zach McDaniel with a really rough race. He was non-competitive in that entire race at Lucas Oil. I ended up finishing 22nd, which is his worst points finish of the season and of his FTSR career, if you can believe that, guys. And On top of that, he lost 22 championship points to 10 Bills. He came into the race last week 9 points back. He's coming into this race 31 points back, so he has a lot of digging to do.
Yeah, he really does. As we look at the points now with Tim Bills leading the way, Bernard Person in second place, always highly dangerous. That eight truck is teammate Brian Helm in third, 29 back. The aforementioned Zach McDaniel in fourth, 31 back. He's got Chernesky, Royal, Terrell, Williford, Schwartz, and Grassy rounding out the top 10 in points.
Yeah, and if you look at those, the point standings there, Dean, I mean, the top four in points, they have won all but one of the races. So, I mean, this has been very competitive league. A lot of different guys have led laps, and you know, several guys have led a lot of laps in this league. But when you look at it, Tim Bills, Zach McDaniel both with two wins, Bernard Person, Brian Helm both with one. And then you got a guy in fifth place, Russell Chernesky, who's coming off back-to-back second-place finishes at two very, very different tracks, and at IRP the last time and Pocono the week before that. So I expect Russell Chernesky to get in victory lane. And then you also have to talk about Bobby Terrell, a guy who has been kind of absent this season. I mean, yeah, he has three top fives and five top tens, but really at the end of the day, he hasn't been very competitive, only leading, hasn't led a single lap, this entire season, which is unheard of for last year's runner-up, Dean.
It really is. I mean, we talk about it each and every week, the quality of the field. As you look at like a Sherwood Williford outside of the top 10, William Long outside of the top 10, a couple of rookies in the top 10, Rachel Hunt, Joe Flanagan sitting in there. A guy we don't give enough credit lately, the 83 of J.J. Spear, already got a race win this year in one of the series, and he's been improving all year. But up and down this lineup, Jared, nothing but quality top to bottom.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about Tim Bills and Brian Helm, Russell Chernesky. Rachel Hunt has just come in the league, has been very solid. I mean, a lot of people know her from her her racing on the official servers, and she's one of the top competitors there. Terry Cooper, I mean, that's a guy, he's coming off a week in Indianapolis, you know, IRP Indy Road Course in Indianapolis, where he didn't finish worse than third place in any of those races. Or fourth place, he finished fourth at the road course. So, very good run for him lately. Joe Flanagan, a guy we were talking to him earlier, Dean, about his run tonight. So I think there's a lot of guys that can win. And then you got a guy like Ronnie Royal, who's sitting second place in points in both our Gearhead Coffee Series, Grand National Series, and the Cup Series. But there he is back there in 11th starting position right now on the grid and hasn't got a win yet in the Truck Series.
Yeah, it's just amazing. Garrett Griffith down there. Lane Allen's down there. I mean, up and down. Like I said, there's no soft spots here, which also brings up passing. You know, we don't know how that's going to go here with this new track config. Jared, what are your thoughts on passing today?
Well, I think Kentucky has always lended itself to be a very multi-groove track. And Dean, something we kind of were remiss to talk about, there was an update yesterday for iRacing, and part of that update was the dynamic track update to allow more rubbering on the track surface itself. So it'll be interesting to see how that plays into a impact this race tonight, if it does at all. We don't know yet, because this is going to be our first race with this new patch update.
Yeah, hard to tell how it's all going to play out. We're hoping it'll bring up... We're hoping that it'll bring out some, you know, multi-groove racing, but we'll see. I mean, we've been trying to get that for a long, long time, and, you know, only time will tell whether that actually works or not, or does not work. Right now, the truck's starting to grid up here. Just looking at the board here, familiar face on the top here, Jared, Tim Bills.
Yeah, Tim Bills, I mean, that is his fourth pole position of the year in eight races, so he has been the man to beat in qualifying. There's no doubt about it. I mean, nobody else has more than one. We have several drivers out there that have one pole, and he's out there with four, so he has been the guy in qualifying, Dean.
Yeah, he absolutely has. Doing a great job all season long. Brian Helm's right there. We'll get into our starting lineup in a second here as we wait Tim Bills gridding up, which I believe he has just done. So get right into that starting lineup here. And you can see here on pit road, for some reason, the lighting really down. Guys, down here in the shadows, in there is the 77 of Tim Bills on the pole tonight with a time of 30.558. On the outside of row number one is going to be the 26 of Brian Helm. The 20 of Russell Chernesky will start in third. On the outside of row number two, the 16 of Rachel Hunt. Terry Cooper Jr. will be starting in fifth spot with Joe Flanagan, the rookie, on the outside of that row. The 8 of Bernard Person will be in seventh, along with Bobby Terrell, and the 83 of J.J. Spear will start ninth with Zach McDaniel in 10th.
Going on back to the field, we got row 6, Ronnie Royal and Donnie Stoppitz. Donnie coming off a win in the Deerhead Coffee Series in the road course earlier this week. Sherman Wolford and Gary Griffith in row 7. We got Lane Allen and William Long in row 8. Brian Bliss and Stephen Loomis, his teammate, there in row 9. Those are the last drivers that post the times. We have Wayne Grossi and Casey McMullen back in row 10. Matt Gehringer and Brandon Elder back in row 11. David Hensley and Paul Sargent in row 12. And Ian Spear line out our 25 trucks for tonight here.
Right, there you have it, our starting lineup tonight as we get set to get this thing going here. Tim Bills on the pole, Brian Halm on the outside of row number 1, Turneski and Hunt starting in row 2. This is quite interesting, Jared, as we await the start of this race to see how this new track config will play out. As the 77 rolls him up here to the start-finish line, waiting for the green flag.
Green flag.
She's down and away, and the 77 gets a nice little jump on the inside. Brian Halm doing a great job up high, holding his own there. Turneski trying to push through on the bottom side.
Tim Bills, good start there on the inside, and you know, not to be expected there. I mean, the inside line is always kind of the preferred at the very beginning of the race. It looks like Russell Turneski is going to clear Brian Halm coming off turn 2, Dean.
Yeah, Russell Turneski with that preferred line down the bottom. Going to get that spot. Looks, well, 26, still fighting on the outside. You can fight high in 3, as you see behind him there. Lots of action.
Yeah, looking back there at the Ryan Boyle, I mean, that guy was quiet back there going with Zach McDaniel and Jason Spear. So, all the guys getting races. Some guys trying to move that outside line. I saw Gary Griffin decide in the middle of the pack, even though he had a clear line on the bottom.
Yeah, we see a lot of guys taking different lines here. Looks like it's highly racy conditions as we look in at Spear with Royal behind him. You got McDaniel and Flanagan up high. Donnie Staubach looking for racing room. Lane Allen looking for racing room.
Yeah, Donnie, I mean, that 99 truck, he kind of runs a part-time schedule outside the Cup Series. But when he gets in the truck, Dean, I mean, you know firsthand, I mean, he's one of your teammates out there. He is extremely racing, and I expect to see him toward the front as this race progresses.
There it is. I expect about 12 of these guys to get to the front, but there's not enough room for everybody as they go 3 wide through the corner here. Ronnie Royal up the middle.
Yeah, it was a little bit tight with the 99 truck and the 81 truck there for a second. Sure, with Wilford, the 33, sitting there watching that battle. Tim Mills already put up a little over a half a second lead on Russell Turneski already up front.
Yeah, Tim Bills looking stout again. Turneski, as Helm makes a move to the inside of Russell Turneski.
Ooh, and Helm nearly contact there in the 20 there. Very close, but Brian Helm's going to go ahead and get underneath him there.
Yeah, that's going to allow Terry Cooper Jr. to shoot that gap. He's got, I believe that's the 8 of Bernard Person. A little contact there with Turneski. Turneski getting beat up a little bit. Little freight train there as all those cars go on through.
Yeah, that's the big thing with the trucks. I mean, the truck series, it's so competitive, number one, because of the competition we have, right? But number two is the setups. There's not a lot you can change on the truck compared to, say, the Cup car or heaven forbid, like a F1 car or something. These cars are pretty basic when it comes to top-level racing, and it is harder when you get on the outside groove and it hasn't come in yet. I mean, you get freight trained in a hurry with these trucks, and Russell just was not wanting that at all.
No, he wasn't. Right now, you see up high of Rachel Hunt's getting passed a little bit as we watch Zach McDaniel, the 42, moving up through the field here. Bobby Terrell's on the move. These guys, highly quality drivers, coming towards the front early on.
Yeah, you know, thinking about that four truck of Bobby Terrell, I mean, last year, Dean, I mean, he finished, he covered many races that I was part of, and Brad as well, that were here. Bobby Terrell was always up front, and this season just hasn't really been a truck that's competed for wins. Yeah, he has some top fives. Yeah, he has some top tens. But no laps led, no poles. I just don't know what's going on with that Ford truck this year, but hopefully they can get it back on track by his standards as the season progresses.
I think he's just got the summertime blues, taking a little vacation with the family and a little time away. He'll be back on track. He might be back on track tonight, but right now, totally on track. The 77 continues to lead. Brian Helm sending chase here. Terry Cooper Jr., Bernard Pearson, and Russell Charneski in your top five.
Well, looking at those lap times last time by, Tim Bills down to a 31.2, whereas Brian Helm and Terry Cooper were both running 31.1s. So they are closing that gap up here, Dean. You can kind of see it on the screen now as the 42 truck looks on the inside of the Ford going into the tri-oval.
Yeah, the 42, you got to watch him.
Sorry, Dean. Brian Helm clipped that wall coming into turn two. Turn one, sorry, and thought it was going to cause a wreck, but it looks like everybody went through unscathed.
It's good to hear the 26 escaping danger there early on. We have avoided the early wreck, at least so far, for everybody. So now, maybe that long run capability comes in. And who's, you know, the guys who are good at that, maybe not at the front. I mean, all the guys are good at it, Jared. Who are the experts? I don't even know anymore. There's so much talent here.
That's true, Dean. And you know, somebody that we always talk about is like Casey Nolan. He's a guy that, you know, he had a really good truck, actually, a couple weeks ago. I think it was a Pocono, and ended up getting his first top five of the season. And he has just not had, you know, this is the guy that finished third place last year in trucks, and he's sitting back in 13th in points this year. Always known for having a great long-run truck, always known for playing the strategy to a T, probably better than anybody out there. And yet he has had a really rough season, as has all of Blackwater in the truck series, unfortunately. And maybe tonight, Casey Mullen with this new track configuration could be a guy that finds himself toward the front.
It's possible, but right now he's towards the back. He's got a ton of work to do up in front of him. Oh, and he's into his teammate there, Brandon Elder. A little contact as you see all four Blackwater trucks back here. You got Loomis, Lane Allen, the 51 of Elder, and the 71 of Casey McMullen. And they're all kind of taking different lines and different approaches, trying to figure out what'll work. I mean, the one guy who isn't in that mess at 25, Terry Cooper Jr., up here in front of Russell Charneski, he's got Zach McDaniel behind that, and Zach looking racy tonight.
Yeah, Zach's looking really good, but, you know, going to touch on that Blackwater story, unbelievable enough, Dean, and I know this probably hurts to hear, but there's not a single Blackwater truck in the top 10 in points this year, which is just unreal. I hope that those guys get it back under control. But up front, we got Bernard Pearson breathing all over the 26 of Brian Helm right now. Brian Helm, I think, got a little bit of damage from hitting that wall and going into turn one.
Yeah, Bernard Pearson looking like he wants some racing room, not finding it from his teammate and Brian Helm right now. As he's running a little smoother, a little lower line, 26 pushing up the track, that might wear out that right front a little later on in the run.
And the A-track Bernard, he's been able to get around him now, or getting on the inside at least. Looks like he's going to clear him going into one. Terry Cooper's going to jump in there as well. But Bernard, he cannot let that 77 just pull away because he needs to lead some laps, and he needs to prevent that 77 truck from leading the most laps, because if Tim Bills gets out there and leads the most laps or whatever happens, this championship, you know, it's early. I mean, we still have four races after tonight, but he can't afford to lose any points that he doesn't have to.
No, he really can't. And right now, he is in here with a five-car battle for second place as Russell Charneski continues to move forward and bringing Zach McDaniel along with him. Brian Helm starting to struggle a little bit as he's lost two. I think he's going to lose two more spots here.
Yeah, that 25 truck has consistently been the fast truck. He has yet to dip into the 32s, if you can believe that. So he's still running high 31s, which is faster than our race leader. I expect Terry Cooper to start making a move. I think he's just kind of hanging back, maybe letting his stuff come to him a little bit, maybe showing a little bit more conservative side than we've seen with Terry in the past. But, you know, Russell Charneski's right there as well as Zach McDaniel with those lap times, but they're still slower than the 25 truck. So good luck for him so far.
Yeah, the 25 you brought up earlier, and you know, he's shown a marked improvement. I mean, he was a quality driver from day one, but you know, you come here to full throttle sim racing, you got to learn that it's a lot of green flag racing, how to save your stuff and work the tires and all that. Terry Cooper Jr. has adapted to it, and he is proving that now, as both him and Bernard Person have caught our leader, Tim Bills, in the 77.
Yeah, Tim Bills was 0.2 seconds slower than the both of those guys last time by. So Tim Bills, I don't know if he burned his stuff up or if he's just kind of relaxing a little bit. It's really early in this race, but you know he doesn't want to see that A truck out front because he needs to prevent Bernard from leading laps too. So it's going to be interesting to see how this happens. But the 20 truck and the 42 truck, Russell and Zach, they're coming to the front as well.
Yeah, they're coming. I mean, everybody's coming. It's looking like Tim Bills just maybe not having the long run capability quite there. But, I mean, he is strong still and still leads this race. But we're soon going to have a 5 or maybe 6 car battle for this lead. Maybe yeah, more than Roy, that.
Yeah, Ronnie Royal and Donnie Staubitz back there. The 81 and the 99 truck are actually putting some time in there. And they've decreased their gap down to less than 2 seconds. So we're going to have around 9 cars in this battle, and then behind them, Bobby Terrell and Shirley Williford have. Shirley Williford's moving forward, Bobby Terrell moving back. He's dropped all the way back to 10th place, Nate.
Yeah, Bobby's struggling, probably running a prefab setup tonight, not having the time to work on it, probably burning up those tires a little bit. But you know, I'm going to touch in on Donnie Staubitz here in the 99, another Blackwater car. Blackwater's got 2 separate teams, so we often forget just how many guys are out here, and kind of forgot about Donnie here. Donnie having a really solid run, and another guy who's really improved steadily over the last 6 months, Jared.
Yeah, we got a battle for the lead. It looks like Bernard Person's going to take that lead from Tim Bills. Terry Cooper looks like he's going to follow through here to go back up to the battle here. But yeah, Donnie Staubitz has had extreme improvement. Really good in the road course stuff and the short track stuff, which, I mean, that's his background. Former modified racer. So, I mean, he is extremely good talent, but he's figuring out this intermediate stuff real quick, Dean. And I think having those kind of guys around him like Lane Allen and Terry Cooper that have been able to help him and develop has really helped him out a lot.
Absolutely. As we see back here now, the 42 working his way past the 20 of Chernesky, the 81 of Ronnie Royal starting to come forward. So we're starting to see the fast teams here come together as Terry Cooper Jr. all over the bumper of the 77 right now.
Yeah, Terry Cooper, I mean, as we talked about, you know, nobody really in Blackwater, I mean, you might as well say it's over and done with as far as their championship hopes for the Drivers' Championship, but these guys are still out here trying to win races. I mean, Terry Cooper doesn't have anything to play for except winning, where these two guys in front of him have a lot more to play for, so he can afford to be a little bit aggressive here and try to make a move that makes them uncomfortable.
Right now, Bernard Person leading the way. Tim Bills holding on to second as Terry Cooper Jr. tries to get by, sitting in third. You got Zach McDaniel in fourth, Ronnie Royal in fifth, and then it's Chernesky, Helm, Staubitz, Williford, and Bobby Terrell in your top 10.
Man, that's a guy we haven't talked about, Dean. Sure, Williford back there in the 33 truck. He has been putting down some good lap times compared to the top guys. I mean, he is the fastest truck on the track for the last 4 laps here. So he has been catching the back of his pack, and now we have pretty much a 9-car battle for the top 9 positions, all within 2 seconds. So very, very close, compact field here tonight in Kentucky.
It really is, as we've already clicked off almost a quarter of this race on lap 23 of 100, and caution hits a track.
Let's see if we can find what happened here. It looks like issue with Wayne Grassi in the 5 truck, Dean.
Yeah, we're going to get on that right away. As we get to it, you see 3 wide here with the 14 and 71 on either side of them heading down into the corner. Grassi in the middle. A little contact from the 71, and around he goes. Oh, and Stephen Loomis with a big piece of that. That's going to hurt his hopes tonight. Take another look. Maybe from the chase cam here. So we see Wayne come in. 77 kind of in their heart. It's hard to tell. You'd need more views to assess, but super unfortunate for the 5. And, of course, the 17.
Yeah, big time. issues for those guys. It looks like, you know, looking at the TV cam too, looks like Casey just looked like he kind of got loose, actually. The back end starts stepping around, and the back right rear looks like it actually made contact with Wayne Grassi first. So I think he just got loose going in there, and that's what happened, unfortunately. But tough break for Wayne Grassi. I think he would have been fine, but that impact from the 17 truck might have cost him his, any kind of good finish tonight, unfortunately.
Super unfortunate. We sit here, we watch the 77. He's downing in perfectly. Looks like everybody getting into their stalls good. We watch the race off of pit road here. 77 looks, well, we're getting to the line. He's squirrely. The 8's going to get it. The 77 in second. The 8 was the leader going in, so he's going to maintain that. Terry Cooper Jr., Zach McDaniel, Ronnie Royal. Looks all status quo in the top 5 or 6.
No change.
Maybe Ronnie Royal gained a couple.
Yeah, Matt Gehringer, first off, he stayed out. He did not pit. So I assume Matt will come in and pit here in a minute. He just probably wants to lead a lap. But, Zach McDaniel, Ronnie Royal was the only driver that gained a spot. He passed up on Russell Chernesky. But Bobby Terrell actually is the big gainer. He went from 11th place on the track up to 7th. So big gain on pit road for Bobby.
Wow, excellent job by the 4 truck, gaining back some of that track position, hopefully getting a couple of adjustments done and improving that vehicle. But we're a quarter of the way through. This throws a loop into any fuel mileage strategy, which we hadn't talked about yet during the race, Jared. That's possibly what was going on at the back of the field. Hard to say, but that is out the window now.
Yeah, it is. But they're still going to have to make another pit stop, Dean. I don't think they have enough to go all the way, so it's going to be really crucial to see when you're going to pit. And Dean, I'm getting word that Donnie Stoblitz had a speeding penalty, and he's going to have to drop to the end of the longest line.
Wow, super unfortunate. What a great night the 99 was having. That's going to be killer. He'll have to persevere through this to get a good finish tonight.
Yeah, and I'm also hearing that Brian Helm repaired his damage, so he's back pretty far back in the pack as well. Looks like he's going to roll off around 22nd or 21st. So those two trucks, both were in the front earlier, Dean, and now they're going to have to really work their way toward back up toward the front.
Yeah, another Brian Helm, extremely fast at the start. Faded a little bit, but looks like he might be having a little issue with the 12 truck there. I'm not sure what's going on with those guys. A little position shuffling.
Yeah, there's no love lost there between those two guys, but
it looks like there's potentially some incidents, as a 12 looks like a shark circling the waters.
We saw these guys get together at Pocono and some heated exchange there, so I don't know if that's still lingering, but anyway.
Well, if it's one thing we know, Jared, is race car drivers don't forget. I mean, I've heard people bring up stuff from the early 2000s when they're talking about someone. So, you know, they never forget, especially an accident. They may forget a win, but they'll never forget it when you get taken out.
No, that's right, Dean. Us racers, you know, I mean, we always have those long memory banks. We're like elephants.
That's exactly right. Right now, Bernard Persson sitting on the point. The 77 of Tim Bills in second. Terry Cooper Jr. running third. In fourth is a 42 of Zach McDaniel. The 81 of Ronnie Royal sitting in fifth. You got Chernesky, Terrell, Sherwood, Williford, Griffith, and Lane Allen up to 10th. So Griffith and Allen showing up here in the top 10 now.
Yeah, and we also, real quick here, Dean, we had a couple trucks come back in pit road. Ian Spear, Donnie Stoblitz, Brian Helm, and Jason Spear. They were all topping up on gas. So, you know, trying to maybe stretch it a little bit, trying to get a little bit of different strategy there. But yeah, Lane Allen, I mean, making his way to the front, he avoided that wreck with Casey McMullen and Wayne Grassi. So he was able to get through there. But honestly, Dean, I mean, the top 8 trucks that we've seen tonight have really been really solid, and I think that these guys back here from 9th on back, you know, excluding Donnie and Brian Helm back there, I think these guys, they really hopefully have made some adjustments there, because they were starting to become about a half a lap down before that caution came out.
Yeah, we've seen that top 8 or 9 that were really competitive. I mean, it was anybody's race early on there. But after that, you got into a few guys who need some adjustments. Bobby Terrell being one of them. He gained that track position on pit road. Did he do something to make that car a little better?
Yeah, and this is one of those opportunities when, you know, the first thing you kind of look at is tire pressures and grill tape. I mean, you obviously the track's cooling down, the air temperature's cooling down. Maybe increase that grill tape. Maybe decrease those tire pressures a little bit. Get a little bit more top speed out of that truck. Bobby Terrell's such a smart racer, and you know he's made some sort of adjustment on that truck to try to get some more forward bite probably.
Yeah, I'm sure he's done all he can do to get that thing handling better. So just do a little volume check here. If a listener could let us know if you can hear me or Jared correctly here. We just had a note on the board there, Jared, a little bit ago about they said they could hardly hear him, but I don't know which one of us is him, so.
Gotcha, Dean. Listening to it right now.
Green flag, green flag.
And the green flag drops again. Bernard Persson down on the inside. Gonna lead him down here. He's got the 77 on the outside, fighting hard to maintain that second spot.
Yeah, and Bernard Persson three wide behind him, though. We're almost three wide. The 33 truck and the 14 truck were there on the outside of the 21 truck, but Bernard Persson controlling this pace now.
Yeah, Bernard Persson doing an excellent job. Terry Cooper Jr. right there on the bumper of the 77. The 42 has made his way up to fourth spot. He's going to be fighting hard. You never count out Zach McDaniel. This battle rages on here.
Terry's looking, I mean, the 25 truck is looking really, really hard there, but couldn't get in. Tim Bills nearly ran over Bernard Persson there, and he's going to get a run come off turn two, Dean.
Yeah, Tim Bills has that short run truck. He wants that lead back badly. He's down to the inside. We'll see what Bernard Persson, who can finally out of that groove. It looks like his truck can handle anywhere, high or low.
Yeah, and Terry Cooper, I thought, was going to stick his nose underneath the Tim Bills, but he's thought wiser of it. And he's there. I mean, this is a three-car battle for the lead, with Zach McDaniel just waiting for something to shake out.
Yeah, crafty Zach will be sitting back there, and he looked to 25, diving a little bit lower there. He's going to try and nose in there on the 77. Boy, this is tough racing here.
You got to get your positions on these restarts as much as you can. You see Tim Bills maybe peeking to the outside. Will he take a gamble there? I don't know. But the 25 truck, I thought he had Zach McDaniel with him, but decided not to go for that move as he makes another run going into turn one. He just doesn't have that straight line speed he needs to get a run on Tim Bills there.
Amazing job by these guys as they race so hard and so close.
And Tim Bills just kind of stalking the A truck, wants him to make a mistake. And the 81 truck threw it in there pretty deep. He's going to gain a little bit of time on Zach McDaniel there, going in three and four. So we got six, seven, eight trucks here within a second.
They're all here, the whole field. I mean, it's unbelievable. You go back to Casey McMullen and Sherwood Williford back here fighting, Lane Allen. You got David Hensley in the mix back here. They all kind of get single file here, Jared.
Yeah, and this is kind of what we saw the first time around. A lot of racingness on that beginning run, and then they kind of settle in a little bit. And Zach McDaniel kind of taking a look underneath the 25. He's got the nose there, so Terry Cooper going to get shoved to the high side. He's going to have to make quick work of this, otherwise Terry could be in position to lose some spots. He dives in there, so he doesn't lose anything except that one spot.
Yeah, Zach McDaniel up to third place, getting dangerous. I mean, that 42, when he gets hooked up, boy, he is tough to beat. But up front, Bernard Persson is keeping that lead, keeping that 77 in check, and he's going to be real tough to run down.
Yeah, and if you're Zach McDaniel, I mean, yes, you're doing great in this race, but the problem is you're now 31 points back thanks to the race last week at Lucas Oil. and the two guys you're trying to catch in points are the two guys in front of you in points. So it is not what Zach McDaniel wants. He wants these two guys to take each other out if they could, I guess, if he needs to get back into this championship battle. But man, it's going to be a heck of a race either way, and Zach McDaniel's closing on these guys.
They're all closing. Chernesky back on the move, looking down low. Not quite there yet. Bobby Terrell looking a little better this run. We'll see if his car can hang on. Ronnie Royal. We got Griffiths back here. Gary Griffiths doing a nice job.
Yeah, I was about to say, the 21 truck, he's decided to make his presence felt in the top 10 tonight. He was running around the mid-teens, I think, earlier, and maybe made some adjustments on that 21 truck. The highest running Ford in the field right now there, so good run for Gary Griffiths.
Yeah, super good run for him. The 71's back there. You got Williford, Lane Allen all back in here.
Yeah, and sure, Williford before that caution, he was the real loser on that caution. I mean, he dropped, went from ninth place to 13th place. So he's having to kind of work his way back up toward the top. So he had a rough pit stop compared to the other guys around him. And now he's going to have to work his way back through traffic to get back to the front.
Yeah, super tough for the 33. He was the fastest truck on the track at the end of that run. So we'll see if he can do that again, but a lot of work to do for sure.
Yeah, and it's just hard, you know, when you're trying to work your way through traffic and there's just not a lot of room to go. You have to really time your runs correctly and things like that. Or you have to wait for everybody else's tires to fall off if you have such a good long run truck like that. So it makes it really difficult to figure out what you're trying to do, as we see the 42 truck getting on the inside of the 77, Dean.
Yeah, 77 pushing a little high there on exit of the corner. Easy to do here at Kentucky.
And Tim Bills, I feel like Tim Bills, and this is just my feel, I feel like he's pushing this run just a little bit harder here, Dean. I think he doesn't like the fact the A truck's leading this race, and he needs to get back out. Probably his truck is set up for being out front, a little bit more trimmed out and things like that than Bernard Person, who had to come through the pack to get to the front. So I think that Tim Bills is maybe just driving just a little bit too hard, as we see Ronnie Royal looking on the outside of the 25 truck.
Yeah, Ronnie Royal looking really strong here. Been tough all season long. And he's looking for racing room, but Terry Cooper Jr. not going to give that up easily.
I don't know if he can make a run going into turn one on the outside, but he just didn't have quite the positioning he needed. And the 42 truck looking again on the 77.
He might have him this time, Jared. Down on the inside, side by side, through to the start-finish line here. You're going to be down into one. I think the 42's got the preferred line here.
Yeah, and then right behind them, Dean, the 81 truck on the inside of the 25 truck, but Terry Cooper doing a pretty good job battling back on the outside, so maybe that outside groove is coming in. And we see the 42 truck finally clear him.
Yeah, the 42's got the spot. Ronnie Royal will probably get the spot down here, but as you said, the 25 doing an excellent job on the outside, and both those guys staying off each other. Excellent driving. That's going to bring Chernesky right into this mess.
Yeah, the 25 truck is hanging on the outside really strong. His lap times didn't even drop off that much. I mean, he's got something figured out on that high groove. Maybe there is some grip developing out there, Dean. I don't know. I'd love to see it, though.
Well, the run he just got through there, either Ronnie Royal got through there slow, or he went like a rocket because he just powered around him. As in now, Ronnie Royal's got his hands full. He got the 4 coming to the 20. The 20's coming to the 81. Everybody getting bunched up here.
Yeah, and sure, Williford on the inside of Casey McMullen, too. Bobby Terrell dives underneath the 20. So we got battles for the back half of the top 10 as the leaders are going to catch some lap traffic of the Wayne Grassi 5 truck.
Yeah, Wayne involved in that early wreck. Unfortunate for him. As we watch his battle between the 4 and the 20, Bobby Terrell, Russell Chernesky.
Yeah, and I saw Casey McMullen make another power move on the outside line. So I think that outside line might have some grip out there, Dean. Because he was able to hold off and pass the 33 truck, and now he's looking on the outside of the 4 truck.
I think it might be developing. This could be iRacing getting something right. We could have multi-group racing as we see the 33 trying to get in this mix with the 4 and the 71. Casey McMullen powering around the outside, and we watched his teammate Terry Cooper Jr. do that. Maybe a message was relayed. Hey guys, the outside line is coming in.
Yeah, and he's cleared the four truck, dude. He has cleared the four truck on the outside line. So that is exciting to see, because now this track has opened up and we might have some racing on our hands, dude.
Yeah, it'd be amazing to see if that line has almost three wide. Oh, and Bobby Terrell's wrecked the 33 into the four. Oh, boy.
Unbelievable wreck there. And that's the danger of catching the lap traffic in the wrong spot there. And it just kind of put those guys off going into that turn, unfortunately.
Yeah, we're going to have a look here. Chase cam, first of all. See, Bobby's now three wide. 33 just wiggling a little bit. Maybe the four coming up. So hard to tell. Take another look, maybe from the chopper cam here. Oh, we didn't have the first look up anyway. So here we go, folks. Three wide there with the lap traffic. And 33 just kind of wiggles. I think he's just trying to find his entry to the corner. Just bad timing there. So tough to call these things.
Yeah, that was tough. It looked like to me that those two trucks just came together. I mean, at the end of the day, they just, Bobby was trying to make the turn coming up, and Sherwood was trying to make the turn coming down, and they just kind of collided there. It's really unfortunate because both these trucks, we know Sherwood had such a great long run truck, and he might have been pretty competitive if this race had gone green, but unfortunately, both those trucks probably out of contention for the win now.
Yeah, that's super tough. Sherwood, I mean, that's kind of a product of that bad pit stop, too. You get back in traffic like that, these things can happen. So tough on the 33 and the 4, of course. Right now, the 8 leading them down pit road.
Yeah, and these guys, I was looking around, Dean, to see if anybody was staying out. It looks like every single truck is coming down pit road. We talked about Donnie Staubitz having to start the tail end. He made his way from 23rd. On the start there all the way up to 14th, so he was making some hay, but otherwise everybody coming in, including those damaged trucks.
Yeah, everybody down here, the leaders are in. We'll see if that first stall is of any benefit to the 77 of Tim Bills. We see
42 Zach trucks away.
42 is down first. He's going to beat him off. Did he get four tires? What an amazing stop by the 42, taking the lead, jumping two spots. Tim Bills also beats off Bernard Person. So Bernard Person now back to third place.
Yeah, Jack McDaniel just had the second quickest pit stop. I mean, he did his out time, or in time, was 43.1. Tim Bills and Terry Cooper Jr. had both had 43s. But tough break for Bernard Person. He was a 44.4, so I don't know what happened to Bernard on that one, but it was not a good pit stop for that 8 truck.
Yeah, super strange there that there'd be any real difference there. Just where you're lined up in the stall, I guess, is pretty much the deciding factor there. But the 42 now has made his way to the point. Zach McDaniel going to be awfully tough once he gets out front here.
Yeah, and we see that Bobby Terrell has officially retired from the race, so this season kind of getting a little bit harder as the races go on. That will leave us down to 23 trucks on the field. Brandon Elder already retired from the race earlier.
Yeah, it's a shame to see both those guys out of the race. Right now, though, Zach McDaniel started 10th, is now showing in first place. You got Tim Bills, who was our pole sitter. He's sitting in second. Bernard Person from 7th up to 3rd place. Terry Cooper Jr. Was started 5th, currently shown in 4th. The 81 of Ronnie Royal has come from 11th up to 5th. And behind him, that looks like Casey McMullen's on the move. He's up from 20th spot up to 6th spot. Good job by him. Russell Chernowski up here in 7th. Good run by Gary Griffith tonight, moving up from 14th to 8th. You got Brian Helm trying to work his way back up here after starting 2nd. He sits in 9th. David Hensley has cracked the top 10 after starting 23rd. Nice run for the SDP.
Yeah, we haven't really talked about that 43 truck, but David Hensley's been consistent. He somehow finds a way to finish in the top 10 or around that point, 10th, 11th, 12th in every one of these truck races. So I expect him to kind of make a move now that he's got some track position. And Dean, you were talking about earlier, fuel mileage, it's out of it now. But guess what? Look at the lap we're on. We're on lap 48. These guys, it's going to be very close. We know they can get around 50 laps, and they're probably going to be able to make it, but it's just going to be really close to know if they can or not, as we see sure Williford has retired from the race as well.
Yeah, that's a terrible accident for those guys, and seeing them retire, what a shame that is. We see a couple of guys on pit road. We got the 18 of Brian Bliss, the 19 of Paul Sargeant. As they come in and top up on fuel, I would think. This could be a fuel mileage move. Yes, the 18 just topping up, down and away. Looks like it's the same for the 19 of Paul Sargeant. So, yeah, they're thinking fuel mileage here.
Yeah, I think both those trucks are pretty much going to be good to go. I don't know exactly how good these guys up front are going to be. Obviously, running caution laps and things like that's going to play a part. But you're looking at still saving about a lap or two, but I think a lot of these guys, especially those that are trying to race their way through the pack, are going to be cutting it really close on fuel.
Yeah, they really are. I mean, it's going to be incredibly close on fuel. Now, how many pit stops have we made here for tires, Jared? We only have 3 sets available in the garage.
Yeah, if we get another caution and these guys come down, they'll all be out of tires. So everybody has pitted twice and taken tires twice, so everybody still has 1 set available to them. Nobody that I'm aware of, per my live timing here, has not taken a set of tires yet.
As we look back on the 16 here, Rachel Hunt, as she comes down pit road, maybe. Yes, I think she's going to come in and top up, and so is JJ Spear. Looks like Ian Spear in the 32 also coming down. David Hensley's in from the 10th spot. So, yes, definitely fuel mileage considerations from these guys.
Yeah, and 2 of those guys are on the same team, Ian Spear and David Hensley, there on Spear Motorsports. So I think that there might have been a call down, like, hey, you know, we have to split the strategy. I mean, Bernard has to stay where he's at. I mean, he can't give up that track position for a gamble. But these guys, you know, if you're back in 10th, come down pit road. Get yourself some fresh, obviously get your tires, but top off on the fuel when you have a chance to. And maybe you can get something, pull something out of the bag. Maybe it's not a win, but it might be a top 5 compared to a 15th.
Yeah, one of the luxuries of having a team where you can play these strategy games, have one guy come in and do it and one guy stay out, and you got it covered on both ends. Often do that with tires, too. You know, sometimes a guy will take no sets just to have that angle covered. So always nice to have friends.
Yeah, and we've seen the 43 truck do that David Hensley do that in other series. Especially at the restrictor plate, it's known for really playing that fuel mileage game to a T at the restrictor plate races and finding himself in competition toward the end of those races. We'll see if it plays out for that 43 truck tonight as we're about to go green, Dean.
Yeah, we're about to go back to green. Super exciting here to see what the 42 can do with the lead, what the 8 can do from third here. Terry Cooper in there, Tim Bill's in there, Ronnie Royal's got his shot, and Casey McMullen now in the top 6.
Green flag, and Casey McMullen.
It's okay. Flags out. 42 is down and away. Looks like the 8 going to try and power through with him. I think he's going to grab that second spot away from Tim Bills. Will he get freight trained or can he get down there?
Yeah, sorry, Dean, about the start there. I just noticed Casey McMullen just kind of sounded something weird in his truck there. I don't know if he missed a gear at the start, but it really stacked everybody up there on the start. And we see that they're stacking up big time behind him.
Yeah, it definitely looks like something happened there as he has lost 4 or 5, maybe more spots. And he is still in the mix of a big fight back here now.
Yeah, it just sounded like, you know, I was on board with him. It just sounded like something just missed on the truck there. I don't know if he spun the tires or tried to anticipate that start and had to get back out of it. But interesting situation there for Casey McMullen. He's dropping like a fly right now. And you see the 70, the 81 truck looking on the inside of the 77. So Ronnie Royal starting to get racy, Dean.
Yeah, Ronnie Royal's definitely getting racy. You know, that 71, though, always thinking about fuel mileage. He might be just up there conserving fuel. Hard to say as Terry Cooper Jr. looks to the inside of Ronnie Royal.
Yeah, Terry Cooper starting to get back toward the front there. I mean, he had a decent pit stop, and we've seen the fastest lap of the race being turned that time by Bernard Persson. So this track has picked up some speed here, Dean, as the race has gone on.
Yeah, it seems like this rubber wearing in has been improved and looking good out here for these guys, as we're going to have some 2-wide racing here for the rest of the night.
Now, it's really impressive to see both the 25 truck and the 71 truck be able to battle on the outside. Ooh, Russell Tranesky really cut it close there, getting in front of Ronnie Royal on the outside. I thought they were going to make some contact back there, but everybody's good to go.
Good to go. That's Terry Cooper Jr. is going to move his way up to fourth place on the move again. Brian Helm now working his way back up towards the front after that early problem. Joe Flanagan back here having himself a nice run. And Casey McMullen still fighting for these spots back here.
And Casey making a move underneath that 53 truck of Joe Flanagan. We got a battle for the lead. The 8 truck is on the inside of the 42. But nothing happened.
Yeah, nothing doing that time. And now he's going to have the 77 to deal with as Tim Bills looks to the inside of the 8 truck.
Yeah, I think he just overdrove that turn trying to get underneath the 42, and that's going to give up that spot to the 77, Dean. And that's going to play right into that 25 in the 20 truck.
You see the run the 8 got on that high line, though, as it comes in. And I think if these guys figure that out, it might be faster up there.
Yeah, holy cow, he turned a lap. He salvaged that lap. I didn't think he would be anywhere near what he was running with Zach McDaniel, but he actually pulled within a couple hundredths of Zach McDaniel that lap, despite having that big mess up in turn 1 and 2. Is that outside line really coming in? And when will these guys start moving up there and running up there?
It's so hard to break the tendencies that you have over time. You learn to run that bottom. But whoever does move up there, I think, especially in 3 and 4, there seems to be an advantage there.
See, again, they're compacted back up. The top five are right there. Tim Bills holding on to that spot, but Terry Cooper Jr. is coming as well. And you see Tim Bills kind of starting to move up a little bit in 3 and 4. Maybe just kind of getting a little bit of a taste to see what that truck's going to do up there. But Terry Cooper moved up, and he gained right up on the back bumper of that 77 truck. So there's something up there, Dean.
There's definitely something up there. There's no doubt about it. We get one heck of a runoff.
And look further back, Donnie Stobbitz has found his way back into the top 10, running 9th place in that 99 truck. So despite that miscue on pit road, he's put himself back to where he was before that first caution. And now he's going to start moving his way to the front of the pack.
Yeah, good to see the 99 back on the move. Back up front, we got Terry Cooper Jr. once again looking to the inside of the 77 of Tim Bills. So hard right now to make that stick down there.
And you see, right there, coming off turn two, right in the middle of turn two there, the 77 truck just has so much power. Number one, because he's able to hold that 25 truck down, but number two, because there's just some grip out there. Let's see how 3 and 4 go.
Yeah, 3 and 4, they really seem to get a big run. You can see it there. Terry Cooper doing a great job staying as he goes side by side to the line here.
And you see Bernard Person, he's kind of looking to the outside. He's going to deke him, and now he's going to go underneath them going into one.
He is, as Terry Cooper is on the inside of the 77. The 8 taking the lead away from the 42.
Trying anyway.
Thrilling action here. Side-by-side racing here at Kentucky Speedway as the 8 does clear him and take the lead. Put Bernard Person back on the point. The 25 continues to fight the 77 for third spot.
These guys are battling hard for that 77 truck, and or for third place, the 25 and the 77. That really shows just how tight that outside line is. I don't know if there's a specific advantage to run that outside line, like where you're running quicker lap times, but you're making it hell for somebody to try to pass you on the inside right now.
You really are behind him. Brian Helm making a move on the 20 as they continue side by side here for about 5 consecutive laps. And they're going to come to the line neck and neck, side by side again.
Yeah, and as we talked about earlier, Dean, I mean, Terry Cooper but for all intents and purposes, his championship hopes are over with. He has nothing to race for except for race wins. And he's really just out here driving hard. Tim Bills is the guy that's got to think.
Oh, and he's loose. He's sideways through the corner of the 25 there, drifting the car up the track. He's going to lose several spots because of that.
There's that controlled aggression we were talking about, but now he's on the outside and making a move on the 20 truck.
You're not willing to give that spot up right back to the bumper of the 20.
This is where our battles are right now on the track. The first place in second place are really close, but that's pretty much it, is this gaggle of cars. We haven't used gaggle tonight, Dean. I had to throw it in there, but we got a gaggle now.
We got a gaggle for sure. As the 81 now starts to make his move, Ronnie Royal down to the inside of Casey McMullen.
You see that 71 truck was one of those trucks that was making it work on the outside. You see Donnie Stobbins kind of moving to the outside line, trying to help out his teammate there. So can these Blackwater trucks figure out something on that high side and start moving toward the front and join up with their 25 truck teammate?
Yeah, I think they are. They're making it work out there. You see Casey McMullen, he's starting to really figure out that groove. And you see the run he gets down the straightaway.
Yeah, and Donnie Stobbins moved up to the high side as well. And you see Terry Cooper trying to fight off Brian Helm there. And Ronnie Royal's going to go way outside. That's the deep outside line.
That's the deep outside line. I'm not sure that one's come in yet, but it was worth a shot. Right now it's Person and McDaniel up front. Bills, Terneski, Cooper Jr. Chasing them. Helm, McMullen, Royal, Stobbins, and Lane Allen rounding out your top 10.
And these guys are going to catch some lap traffic. Rachel Hunt back there and Stephen Loomis are a little less than a straightaway ahead of them. Rachel Hunt, I'm not sure what happened, but she was on the lead lap, and I think there was a hang-up on pit road or something that happened, and she had to make a green flag pit stop. Maybe she got black flag for entering a closed pit. I'm not sure, but ended up having to come in, and now she's the last car running on the track, one lap down in 20th.
Yeah, that's a good chance that's what happened. I know they were topping up for fuel, trying to make a fuel mileage out of it. Perhaps now with the way that works down on pit road, you can't come in for that last little dash on that last lap or you'll get black flags. So she might have got caught up in that.
Dean, I was watching Tim Bills and Russell Terneski in 3 and 4. Those guys are running single file, but yet they've moved up a groove in 3 and 4. So I think these guys are starting to figure out that there's some grip out there if they can get it working. Casey Mullen's moving to the front, Dean. Sorry.
Yeah, all these guys starting to figure it out a little bit. A little antsy about moving up there, but they're starting to figure it out.
You see, Casey McMullen, he's not even trying to go on the low side. He is running that middle to second groove, somewhere in between that first and second groove there, and he's gaining so much time on Brian Helm in front of him. He's been able to just kind of cook down on him. You see Ronnie Royal now battling with Terry Cooper for that position there in seventh place. Three wide behind him.
Yeah, there's a big battle there. Terry Cooper getting shuffled back here, perhaps burning up his stuff a little bit. Oh, and the 20 into the wall a little bit, just a touch. He'll be all right.
Yeah, and the top two have kind of checked out. I mean, Tim Bills is now 1.5 seconds back, but he has got a train of trucks behind him that have come to the front. So all the way back to Donnie Stobbins is less than a second difference from third to ninth place right now. So this is a tight group. And a lot of positions could change hands here really quick.
They really could. And you've got to think about pit stops, too. So if you pitted with, say, 50 to go, you know, that you split it in half, that's on 25. Do you think these guys can make it 50 running this hard? I don't think they can, Jared.
We know that 50 laps was the number that a lot of teams were talking about today on fuel. They didn't really think it was going to come into play because of tires, actually, because of how much this track eats tires. So maybe the question we're asking is, you know, do you pit for tires or do you just suffer with a really ill-handling race car as this track kind of comes in? You see Lane Allen back here in the 14 truck make a power move on the outside on the 53 truck. That Blackwater team's figured out the outside groove, Dean.
Yeah, they're starting to make that work for sure. But interesting decision. We've seen this several times play out. Guys too scared to come down pit road. Even if they can't make it on fuel, they decide to stay out and do almost a full run and come in with, say, 10 or 15 to go. I think if someone gets on pit road 5 laps from now, if in fact they have to pit, that they will come out the beneficiary with that huge track position.
Yeah, Dean, and I thought we were going to have a caution there. Brian Helm, Russell Terneski, and Tim Bills were three wide going into turn one, but Brian Helm wisely backed out of there. But man, this group is battling so hard right now. I mean, I don't know if fuel's on the table, but tires surely are on the table, Dean. And if I'm a guy like, you know, Joe Flanagan or Matt Geringer back there in 11th and 12th position, David Hensley, who topped off, if I'm Matt Geringer or Joe Flanagan, I would gamble. I would just come to the pits and just say, I'm going with this strategy, and maybe I'll finish 19th, but I'm not going to win any other way, and maybe pull something out of the bag.
Yeah, I got to agree with you. I don't know. When you see a Casey McMullen Sr. up here racing this hard, you got to think they can all make it, or they can't. One of the two, because if he thought he could stretch fuel, he'd be doing so. But back up front, Bernard Persson leading the 42 of Zach McDaniel as these two keep mirroring each other's track times. Round and round they go, sitting 1 and 2.
Yeah, and these guys back here from third on back, I don't think they care about the win, or maybe they don't think they can get the win now, because they're racing like it's the last lap. And Casey McMullen looking on the outside of the 77 truck. Russell Tronesky and Brian Helm have been able to pull out. Ooh, 10 bills a little bit loose coming out of four. And that's going to allow Casey McMullen to power by on the outside.
That's about the fifth truck he's passed on the outside. So the 71 really making that outside lane work.
Yeah, this is, I mean, his best race to date. I mean, Pocono, he finished in the top five, but I mean, he really wasn't there most of the race. He just kind of got with that strategy. But this race, he's actually looked competitive. Looks like a truck that could actually maybe compete with a win if he had a little bit better track position, or maybe a yellow comes out.
Yeah, as a former champion you're talking about, I'm sure he stumbled a little bit, but you can't hold down a Casey McMullen Sr. for long as he's powering on through here behind him. The 81 of Ronnie Royal starting to assert himself. Here comes Donnie Staubitz in the 99 as they all go by Tim Bills in the 77.
Yeah, I think Tim Bills and Terry Cooper burned their stuff up. These guys are dropping like flies, and that's great news for Zach McDaniel. Who's going to try to gain some points on 10 Bills tonight. But he needs to get away from Bernard Persson as he takes that lead back from Bernard there going through turn one.
Yeah, it looks like the 8 truck's starting to fail a little bit here, or perhaps just a single bad lap. I'm not sure what happened there. But right now, Zach McDaniel, your new race leader, once again, he was the leader coming off pit road, so doing a great job out here. Zach, really tough to beat when you get him some clean air.
Yeah, and the thing is, Dean, we've talked about Zach McDaniel. I mean, he ripped off 3 races in a row last season. This season, he started off the season dominating several of these races, but it's mistakes, right? I mean, it's the mistake that happened at Kansas, I think it was, or maybe Chicagoland, where he missed pit road and ended up dropping from second position to 13th finishing. It was last week at IRP where he just missed on the setup and got caught up in a couple wrecks and finished 22nd. If you take those two finishes out of this season for him, he is our championship leader. I mean, by no means is he a slouch or anything like that, but he had some bad races. He's in the pits, Dean. He's in the pits.
All right, the 42, our race leader, first one down pit road. Love the call. If you can't make it, get on pit road. The 42 of Zach McDaniel has done just that. Excellent job by him.
And that's that 25 lap mark you were talking about, Dean. So these guys, either they can't make it like you were talking about earlier, or they can make it and they know it. But Zach McDaniel electing not to. And what's that leave Bernard Persson thinking? Is he can't stay out longer if he can't make it.
Yeah, well,
he's going to start losing time.
If one person makes a call, it usually has a chain reaction. But right now, Bernard Persson going to continue to ride on the track here all alone with a nice big lead. I'm not sure what's going on here. If the 42 made the right call or the wrong call, only time will tell.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to go a lap down. So he's going to come out around where Lane Allen is, maybe around where Gary Griffin is back there. So he's got some bad pit stops. I'm getting word the 26 truck's heading in.
All right, Brian Helm, a couple of Spear Motorsports guys going to head on down to pit road. Looks like a nice clean stop here for the 26, or entry, I should say. Bernard Persson, so all 3 Spear trucks. And we got Joe Flanagan's there as well.
I'm also hearing Donnie Staubitz is coming in next time by, Dean. So these guys starting to make moves toward the pits.
All right, that just leaves, can anybody make it? Who topped up? We've seen Paul Sargeant top up. We've seen Rachel Hunt top up, but unfortunately had a black flag as well. We've seen one other truck down there as well, I believe.
David Hensley.
Or I think it was Ian Spear was down on there. Oh, and Hensley, you're right.
Got more trucks coming in, Dean. Let me see who that is. Joe Flanagan in. Bernard Persson down the way. He might have taken just fuel. I mean, that was a really quick stop for him.
Well, the 26 got in front of the 8 on pit road. So the 8 truck, a burnt-out person losing a huge trunk. He had a 20-car length lead on the 26. He's lost all of that right here on pit road.
Now, I wonder, Dean, I wonder if Tim Bills and Terry Cooper and those guys, what if they weren't maybe running their stuff up, or maybe they just thought that they could make it to the end on gas? But I think the 25 might be a penny.
Yeah, I'm not sure that they would be, they can make it the way they were running. They might have thought about it. I don't know. If anybody could make it, it'd be Casey McMullen, but I highly doubt anybody can with what I've seen out of these guys. We're down on 19 to go here. Right now, Russell Chernowski, your race leader, followed by Casey McMullen and Tim Bills, who they're fighting heavily back here once again.
Yeah, I think at this point, if you're Terry Cooper, Casey McMullen, Russell Chernowski, I think you've kind of made your bet. I mean, you got 17 laps to go. I mean, if you come in now, you're going to lose all that track position. Yeah, you're going to be worse off if you run out of fuel, but man, you have really let it come out here tonight, and I think that's going to be really, really tight. You've made your bet, I think, at this point, Dan. It's going to be really nice to see what happens.
Well, you made your bet, but also don't forget if a caution comes out, just how beneficial this could be. They would be race leaders, and they'd be the only ones with sets of tires left to go get, put them in unbeatable status here, but I don't know. These guys continue to go around. We've got about 10 or 11 guys still yet to pit.
Yeah, and you look at the lap times, Dean. I mean, Zach McDaniel's running about 2 seconds faster than Russell Chernowski, Bernard Person right there as well. So these guys, obviously they have to unlap themselves, but 2 seconds a lap puts Zach McDaniel gaining in 15 laps. So that's going to put Zach McDaniel right on the back bumper of this 20 truck if things hold consistent here. So I think that this is going to be a pretty close finish regardless if anybody can make it on fuel or not.
Yeah, I mean, I would imagine you'll see that level out somewhat. So I don't know how that'll play out, but it'll be interesting nonetheless. Right now, Russell Chernowski continues to lead. McMullen, Bills, Cooper, and Hensley, your top five. Allen, Griffiths, Spear, and Sargent, your top ten.
Yeah, and remember those two Spear guys, Gary Griffin, those guys I don't think they have to pit. I mean, I think they topped off at least to have the option to make it on fuel, I think, because they do have a lot more fuel in the tank than some of these other guys. So, man, it's going to be interesting, Dean. I don't know. I want this race to kind of speed up so we know what happens, but we have to let the laps roll down.
That's it. I mean, these might be your big players, the 32 of Ian Spear and the 19 of Paul Sargent. They both topped up on that one lap. I mean, it's not much, but if they've been pedaling it, if they've been saving, they might be able to make it. 15 to go, coming down to 14 to go.
And we know some of these guys that definitely have, that are staying out. We always see this happen. There's some guys that are going to make it on gas, and it might be a struggle, and they might not win the race because they did this strategy, but we're going to definitely see somebody run out of gas here of these guys that didn't pit yet.
We've seen it all year long. I'm sure we'll see it again.
So I'm looking here, Dean, on last lap pitted. So we go all the way back to the 11th place truck of Brian Bliss, who pitted on lap 48. Paul Sargent on 48 as well. Ian Spear, Jason Spear on 49. Gary Griffin, Lane Allen on 46. David Hensley on 49. Terry Cooper, Tim Bills, Casey McMullen, Russell Chernowski on 46. So right now they're at 40 laps on a tank of gas. So we're going to find out here in about 5 to 10 laps whether they can make it or not.
So interesting. Right now, Zach McDaniel about 23 seconds back of our leader. We're down to 13 to go. I don't think he can make up that much time. Maybe. But right now, so interesting. We don't know where to focus the camera. We don't know who our actual leader is. Well, we know the 20 of Chernowski right now, leader on the track.
Something that's going on back here. I'm trying to figure out maybe a little contact between the 11 and the 43, but no harm, no foul there.
That's good to hear. So we see Ronnie Royal get around our leader, get that lap back. But Russell Chernowski continuing to lead. Now let's talk a little bit about him, Jared. Never won a race here at Full Throttle Sim Racing. He's been the bridesmaid several times. Could this be his night?
Yeah, Dean, he's finished second in the last two races. So Pocono and IRP, two totally different tracks, finished second. He also had a second place finish earlier the year at Kansas as well. Chicagoland earlier this year as well. So he has been on quite a roll. But again, he's been bit by these fuel mileage races. We saw it at Kansas where he did run out of fuel and had to come to pit road and ended up losing that race because of it. So I think that, you know, he's made his bet at this point one way or another. He might grab his maiden victory, which would be amazing to see. He's worked so hard for it. We've heard in his voice in his interviews how much he wants to win and how competitive he's tried to make his truck, his team. And I would love to see it pay off for him. He's a really good guy and really competitive guy.
Yeah, absolutely. He deserves some luck. He deserves a victory. Here he is. He's got a shot. We're at 10 to go here. They're still on the track. As you see Johnny Staubitz go on by, get his lap back.
Yeah, and the real battle is going to be trying to kind of figure out how everybody's going to cycle in for the top 10. That 99 truck, I mean, he could be a good player for a potential top 10 finish here either way. But, I mean, he is really coming to the front. So is Joe Flanagan. Both of these guys will have a lot of stakes still trying to either, A, finish in the top 10 or even compete for possibly a win. We just don't know how things are going to play out. But it looks like Zach McDaniel's way ahead at this point.
Yeah, at least our top 10 here, like you said, they made their bet. So if they can't make it, you've got a whole slew of 10 other drivers who are going to jump 10 spots and have big nights. So they're racing for that as well. It's so intriguing here as we watch a 20 go. And he's actually being run down by both Casey McMullen Sr. and Tim Bills, who are coming in the picture. They're all in the same strategy. So very interesting here.
Yeah, that lap, they were both of those guys were half a second quicker than Russell Tronesky there. I don't know if Russell looked at his fuel gauge and thought, I got to save a little gas. And Casey McMullen and Tim Bills decided they have the gas. But something definitely happened that lap. Let's see what the lap times are now as they come across the line. Let's see. So Russell did a 33.2, and Casey McMullen and Tim Bills did 32.9, so still 4 tenths. At that rate, they're going to catch him here in a couple laps.
Yeah, they're reeling him in and reeling him in quickly as we come down to 7 to go. Russell Chernesky looking for his first ever win at Full Throttle Sim Racing. I mean, he's been snake bit so many times. Can he do it tonight? Casey McMullen is trying to steal that away from him.
And Casey McMullen, I mean, he's had kind of a snake bit in the year, right? I mean, you know, this guy finished third place in points, didn't get a win in Truck Series last year. Started off the Cup season with an amazing win over Ronnie Royal in a very competitive Charlotte race. But man, he's had nothing but bad luck since that first week at Charlotte and all these series. And it'd be great to see him get a win in this Truck Series. But man, I mean, Terry Cooper's not even out of this thing if these guys run out of gas. So, I mean, there's a lot of people still at play here as Zach McDaniel's knocking on the door of a top 10 already. So he's coming to the front.
Yeah, he's coming. He's coming in a hurry.
Down to 5 to go.
5 to go. I mean, Zach McDaniel 15 seconds back. Unless they run out of gas, he is out of the picture. Right now, it's Ken Casey McMullen Sr. run down the 20 of Russell Chernowski, who's seemingly starting to pull back away now.
Yeah, he put down a lap. Actually, Terry Cooper was the quickest driver, or sorry, Tim Bills was the quickest driver that lap by just a couple hundredths, but not enough to really make a move on Casey McMullen there. So like I said, Dean, these guys, I don't think they can pit now. I think they're what they get is what they get.
Well, they're definitely not pitting unless they're sputtering. I mean, unless they're forced to. And I think they're clutching. I think they're doing some trickery here to make this gas last a little bit longer.
Yeah, they're above the 50 lap mark as we come down to 2 to go when Russell hits that start finish line. But man, oh, it's going to be close. It's Gary Griffin's popped his way into the top 5, so he's coming to the front as well. So good run for Gary if he can hold on to that fuel mileage.
Yeah, Gary having himself a real nice run here in the top 5. Absolutely. Back up front. We'll check in on the 20s. 3 to go here, and he's still being hunted down. Looks like the 71's starting to close in. So's the 77. 3 to go. Can the 20 hang on?
Yeah, I think Casey Malone looked at the lap counter. He's like, I've got to go now. If I run out of gas, I run out of gas. He's out of the championship picture. I think he looked down and said, I've got to go. I've got to make something happen as we come down to 2 to go here.
I mean, he's there. So is Tim Bills, Casey McMullen. I mean, the 20 might be low on gas and having to save a little bit. They come up on the lap traffic here. Oh, and McMullen right down to the bumper now. We're on two to go, coming down to one to go. It's going to be Chernesky, McMullen, and Bills fighting for this race win.
And oh, Russell's in the wall. The spark's coming off the 20 truck, and Case McMullen's there. He's going to go to the high side.
He goes up high. A little bit of sparks. They're fighting for everything. The 20 saved a little bit here. We're on the last lap.
Now that 77 truck's right there. So, and now the other question, Dean, can these guys make it back around? As you see, Tim Bills looks on the inside of Case McMullen, and Case McMullen's got a huge run coming in turn two. Can he get there?
He's driving hard on that outside, trying to get that big run. He's right there, looking to the inside. He's not sure. Can he get down? He looks to the inside. The 71 down low, right past the 20. No, Russell Chernesky is going to lose it again. The 77 goes by. I think he's out of gas.
He's out of gas. The 20's out
Casey
of gas,
McMullen going to be your race winner tonight. Excellent job by the 71 of Casey McMullen Sr. managing that fuel, taking home the victory here in the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series. Unbelievable finish we have here at Kentucky Speedway, Jared.
Wow. Russell barely beat Terry Cooper across the line. He ran out, but man, what a race, Dean. What else can you say? What more can you want?
I don't know what more you can want. Unbelievable finishes we've had in this series. Highly competitive. Casey McMullen Sr. taking home the victory. We're going to get words, too, with Russell Chernowski. I mean, I'm almost scared to talk to him. He just can't get that win. The gods won't cooperate with him at all.
Yeah, unbelievable. I mean, Tim Bills and those guys, what a race for Tim Bills. This is huge for him. He beats Bernard Person and leads the most laps tonight. Beats him by six positions. So, I mean, that's huge for the points. I mean, he's starting to put a stamp on this season. And Casey McMullen, this could be the thing that jumpstarts his season. This is his first Truck Series win of 2020. He hasn't won a single Truck Series race this year. This could jumpstart his season in all the series, Dean.
Yeah, I mean, a great night for him, a great night for Blackwater. They've been taking a little grief from you in the booth here, Jared, talking about how bad they've had it. I think Casey McMullen put a stamp on it tonight, starting 20th, takes home the victory, looking great out there. I mean, did his sponsors proud tonight.
Yeah, and then Gary Griffith back there in fifth place. What a run. That's his first top five of the year. David Hensley pulls in a seventh place finish, so good run for here. And how about Ian Spear, Dean? We haven't talked about him at all tonight except making that move. He holds off Zach McDaniel by a little less than a tenth of a second and gets a top 10 place finish in ninth.
Yeah, let's run down that finishing order right now. Casey McMullen Sr. in the 71 with the race win. Tim Bills will take second. Russell Chernowski runs out of gas, falls to third place. A great finish, though. Terry Cooper Jr. will be in fourth. Gary Griffith, the rookie you just talked about, in fifth place in the 21 truck. Great finish for him. JJ Spear, another solid night in the 83 truck, will take sixth. David Hensley with a great job tonight. He'll take seventh in that 43 truck. The eight of Bernard Person falls back to eighth. Ian Spear showing up in the top 10. A great night for the kid tonight in the 32. He'll take home ninth. And Zach McDaniel will round out that top 10.
And looking further back, Paul Sargeant, good run. He was running back in the 20s all race. Ends up with an 11th place finish thanks to that pitch strategy. Ronnie Royal, tough break for him, ends up 12th. Matt Gehringer, 13th. Donnie Staubitz, tough break for him as well, 14th position tonight. Joe Flanagan, 15th there. Brian Bliss, back in 16th with Lane Allen, 17th. Brian Helm, tough break for him. He had, a speeding penalty that cost him the race back there, 18th. And Rachel Hunt, 19th. With Steve Loomis, 20th. They were the last cars running. We had five retirements. Wayne Grossi, Will Long, Bobby Terrell, Sher Williford, and Brandon Elder did not complete the race tonight. Dean, what a race we had, though.
Wow. I'm just sweating. Just talking about it was awesome, man. I'm so excited. What a finish. And I'm also a little disappointed, of course, for Russell. I mean, man, is he snake bit. But, yeah, all in all, man, this truck series, it always has it all. I mean, we got guys losing on pit road. We got guys winning on fuel mileage. We got guys winning from sheer speed, last lap passes. We've had it all this year, Jared.
Yeah, I mean, we think about, go back to Kansas, Brian Helm. I mean, we remember talking to him, and he straight up said he snookered everybody by running down that fuel with, I think, a couple of his teammates chasing him down there at the end of that race, and he managed to make it while guys like Steve Loomis and Brandon Elder ran out of fuel as the race is coming down the end. Tonight, I thought maybe we were going to see a repeat of Kansas, and it ended up being the three trucks were able to make it to the end. Russell just a little bit less gas than the other two behind him. But good night for 10 Bills. I mean, he's starting to put a stamp on this season, like I said earlier. And great night for Blackwater, Dean. I mean, definitely not hating on that team. A lot of great guys over there, but has definitely had a rough truck season so far this year. But great job by that group getting a couple of cars in the top five tonight.
Yeah, they're going to be thrilled with this one. Be back in victory lane. But right now, we're going to take a short break. We'll show you the new, North Wilkesboro, the new track here at iRace. When we come back, we'll get interviews with our top three.
We are back at North Wilkesboro, North Carolina, where the field is rolling out for the start of today's 400 lap race on this 0.625 mile racetrack. And just as the field comes all around turn number four, the sunshine peeks through, helping warm things here. Bill Elliott leads him down. Benny Parsons on the outside. The green flag flies, and the first Union 400 Winston Cup race from North Wilkesboro is underway. Everybody nicely turns number one and two as Bill Elliott has the lead, and Dale Earnhardt has jumped into second position, followed by Benny Parsons and Bobby Allison. Oh, here we go. It's just about to go away. They're both coming out of turn four. Earnhardt gets the lead. We had just heard from our spotters that Neil Martin. Dale Earnhardt is on his last lap. This will be his 24th career win. Dale Earnhardt wins the first Union 400 at North Wilkesboro.
All right, welcome back to the Blackwater Products USA Truck Series. We're here at Kentucky Speedway, where we just watched the last lap, fuel mileage, plus, you know, he was running them down as well. A win for the 71 of Casey McMullen Sr. and a tough break for Russell Charneski. Unbelievable. Big points night for 10 Bills. What a thrilling race, Jared.
Yeah, a huge race for 10 Bills. I mean, yeah, he finished second place, but I mean, he's been on a tear of races ever since he got that first win. He hasn't finished worse than second. And Dean, I think you're down there with the heartbreak, the third place finisher, Russell Charneski.
Yeah, hey, man. And we got Russell Charneski. Russell, man, I'm almost scared to talk to you, but a great night nonetheless. Third place. Still not time for that victory quite yet.
Oh, my God, Dean, I don't know what to tell you now. This is the second time I lost to coming off of four on fuel mileage again. I can't believe it. Oh, boy. I think I'm going to change my number to two or three.
It might be something you have to do. Wow. It was thrilling to watch. We were rooting for you, man. We really, you know, yeah. Talked about it. We thought you had it. We thought you had that curse, so to speak, broken the monkey off your back. We know you're going to get it, and you're going to get many, Russell. But talk a little bit about the right race. Let's start right with at the end. Not the running out part, but just those last 10, 15 laps, what you were thinking, how much you were pedaling it, and how much these guys were catching on you.
Well, from last night, I went 49 laps on a full tank, so I figured it could come down to a one-stop race if it went green, and how this race went with a couple of yellows early. I mean, and then right there at that midpoint, it's like, geez, we can maybe stretch it and make it. And so that was my game plan, considering the truck was pretty much a fifth-place car. The handling was off just a little bit, so that was my game plan. I'm going to stretch it on fuel mileage, and boy, just came up short. I mean, 30 laps in, 20 laps, I thought for sure I was going to make it, but I should have saved a little bit, and I really didn't. It was kind of my fault.
Yeah, these things happen. Let's go back a bit in the race. You know, there was some hard racing out there. It seemed like the track was starting to open up maybe to a multi-groove track. I'm not sure if that was, just us talking about it or if it was actually happening, but it looked like that outside groove was starting to come in, Russ.
Yeah, at some points, depending on the stint of where you are in the tires, I mean, like 3 and 4 was okay in the middle groove, but it seemed like the preferred line for me anyway was still kind of on the bottom in 1 and 2, but my truck was a little bit off. It wasn't there. I mean, Bernie and Zach, I think, had the trucks to beat there, and I think they were running so good and so fast, they were just burning up more fuel, to be honest with you, and, you know, I wasn't because I didn't really have the truck like they did, and it kind of played in my hand, but still in the end, we lost it again. A good win to Casey and good win to Tim. That's a good points night for Tim. And I think he ran out of fuel there too, right after the finish line or something like that.
Oh, wow. Everybody really close. Anyway, it's a good points night, Russ. Another solid finish, you know, second. I mean, you know, it should make
don't
for.
Don't remind me.
It'll make for a good season, a good point season. But you're going to get one, man. We're rooting for you. And congrats tonight on a third place and putting on a thrilling show for us up here in the booth and the people watching. But the floor is yours, man. Anybody you want to thank or.
Yeah, 10-4, of course, Tim and Will and Dylan and Brody and the admins here who put the league together, they do a good job. And, of course, you two doing the broadcast, you guys do an excellent job. It's really nice to watch it the next day.
All right, Jared. That's Russell Chernusky in the 20 truck, man. Snake bit one more time.
Yeah, Dean, and I'm down here with our second place finisher and our point leader, Tim Bills. Tim, what a race, man. I mean, fuel mileage at the end, and he came home second place tonight.
Yeah, we were lucky for the fuel mileage game tonight. You know, usually I'm against that, but tonight I was happy to see that. We just barely made it on the fuel. We didn't have that great of a truck all night. It was a little off on the setup, so we needed something else to help us out.
Yeah, let's talk about that. So at the beginning of the race, I mean, you pulled out to about a 2-second lead over the second place truck, who at the time I do believe was Russell Chernusky or maybe Terry Cooper Jr. at the time. And it looked like you were kind of out there, and then all of a sudden Bernard Person and these guys started chasing you back down, and then the caution came out before they were able to really make a move on you there.
Yeah, they were just a lot faster. Like I said, I took off pretty good, pretty decent, you know, the first couple laps, but it fell off. Just missed it tonight, but got to make good with what we had.
Yeah, and it was a big points night front for you tonight. I mean, you finished second place, you got some laps led. So by my math, you're going to have a 10-point advantage over Bernard Person going into next week. But at the end of that race, we had the caution coming out right at the end. You know, you had the opportunity there. Did you think that you were going to make it on fuel, or were you kind of worried about that fuel with that caution coming out right around the fuel mileage window?
I had no clue if I was going to make it, so I just started saving and watching. And as I just kept watching the fuel, and it seemed like maybe we could make it. And then I just kept being easy the rest of the whole time. I kind of had a feeling that, you know, they were going to run out as hard as Bernie and Zach were going, that there was no way they were going to be able to make it. And it turned to work out for the good.
Yeah, we saw you drop toward the end of that line there, dropping way back. We pretty much assumed you were going to save fuel there, Tim. But, man, you've really put a statement on this season. We got 4 races left. We're going to Loudoun, New Hampshire next week. How are you feeling about a potential championship coming down for that 77 team?
Wow, well, we're going to give it our best shot, that's for sure. Kind of look forward to going back to Loudoun, going to New Hampshire. Races more like a short track. That's kind of where I like to go.
Well, Tim, great race, great season so far. I'm going to let you have the last word tonight. Good run, bud.
Yeah, thanks. I got to thank H&H Sign Supply just for crafters.com. Thank Russell Charnesky again for the help this week. So I couldn't do it without him. And thank you guys for putting the broadcast on.
All right, Dean, that was our second place and point leader, Tim Bills. And I think you're down in victory lane with an excited, elated Casey McMullen in that 71 team.
Yeah, man, we got Casey McMullen, part of that Blackwater Hydrographics team there, part of SBR Racing. Casey McMullen back in victory lane here at Kentucky. Congratulations, man.
Hell yeah, man. This felt so good. man, we had a good track tonight. The whole team did, and Terry Cooper and Lane Allen and Brandon, man, they really set me up for this tonight. And man, it feels good to be back in victory lane. I never thought I would win, but I was working it there at the end. And man, Russ just happened to run out on the backstretch, and man, it just worked out.
Yeah, poor Russell Snakebit just can't get that first victory, but his failure is your win, and you were racing for it anyway. It was going to be a hell of a race at the end there. But let's go back in the race a little bit. So we watched you early on in the race. You know, you're riding around the back a bit. Were you already thinking fuel mileage? Were you thinking, I'm going to try and make it to 50?
Yeah, I had it in my my strategy there, but I think we were fine. I think we could run closer to 52 laps. The more we ran, so I was close the way I was running. But man, I feel sorry for Wayne. Getting into Wayne, I ran up the track and collected him, and man, I just hate that for him and collecting one of my teammates. So I really hate that.
Yeah, that was super tough incident. Things happen out there, though. But early on in the race, so you fight back. The caution comes out. That throws out the fuel mileage strategy. We see you start charging towards the front, laying that gas pedal down, coming up there. You work your way up into the top 10, close to the top 5 even, I think. And then something happens on the restart. Talk about the restart where you dropped off. You lost maybe 5-6 spots.
Yeah, the restart... I was right behind Terry, and the vision was bad, and I couldn't see out in front. Like, I see I had the car on the inside of me, and I had Terry's big old spoiler in front of me, and I just couldn't see, and I had to get off of it, and we were a little 3 wide there, so I had to make sure we didn't mess up a little bit and back out of it. But it came back. I was using that outside lane. That thing just worked really well on the second groove. It just turned really well up there and could hold it in it, hold the throttle down.
Yeah, we noticed you getting that outside lane working, man, and pushing it where nobody else really was at the time, getting these great runs and coming back up there. And just talk a little bit, before Russell ran out, do you think you had something for him on that last lap?
I thought I did, because I went into turn one and I messed up. What happened was, I think I got on the gas just a little tiny bit too early, because I was going to have that outside line where I thought I could have pulled alongside of him coming out of the corner, and I messed it up. And turn three and four, I was hoping he would take the bottom, because I was going to roll that top again, and I thought I could have got him there too, but he was fast, and you know, we were all fast up there. And man, Bernie and the 42 Zach, man, they were in a different zip code, but we were really competitive tonight. I thought I had a chance, even though I was a little bit behind. But man, that sucks for Russ. He's been working real hard, and he just gets so close. And it was fun battling those guys up there. It was just a treat, because I haven't ran this well all year, and I think this is my second interview all season since 2020 started, so it feels pretty good to be up here.
Casey, man, it's great to have you up here. We're so happy for you, so happy for Blackwater, man. Really nice to see you back in victory lane. A big congratulations to you, and the floor is yours, brother.
Yeah, thank my teammates at Blackwater Motorsports, SBR Racing, Steve Berry Racing, and thanks my sponsor, Blackwater Products USA, my wife and kids, of course, so I don't get in trouble. And I'm sorry again, Wayne. I really hate that I got into you, and I really feel bad about that. And yeah, other than that, I'd like to thank the league too, and you guys for putting on a great show.
All right, Jared, that's Casey McMullen, our race winner tonight. Jared, I'm going to have to step away, folks. It's going to wrap it up for me. Jared will take you home. What a thrilling race. Excellent finish. Just more than I could ask for. For me, that'll wrap it up. Jared, it's all yours.
Yeah, what a race we had tonight, everybody. I mean, what a snake-bitten season Casey Mullins had. And then comes out of here with a big victory. And then we see Russell Troneski losing it again on the last lap in the last turn. as we've seen a couple of times before. Next week, we're going to be heading into Loudoun, New Hampshire. First time we visited that track here in 2020, so it's going to be really interesting to see how these guys anticipate and race that track. Tomorrow night, we have another race here in Kentucky with the Gearhead Coffee Grand National Series, 9 p.m. Eastern Time, 8 p.m. Central Time. We'll have that right here on Full Throttle TV. That'll be Dean Doucette and Brad Patterson calling that race. And then, obviously, next week, we'll have, again, Loudoun, New Hampshire for both the Gearhead Coffee Series and the Truck Series. And then we have some other races coming up on the schedule. I don't have that schedule right in front of me right now, but we have some races with ISRA coming up as well on Sunday nights. Guys, that's going to wrap it up for me. I'm Jared Carr for Dean Doucette, Full Throttle TV. Have a great night.